Good evening and welcome to the big story we are tracking. The CBI has arrested a junior engineer of the Uttar Pradesh Irrigation Department who has been involved in some of the most heinous, some of the most grotesque crimes against children that have been reported in several years. Sexual exploitation of children in the age group between 5 and 16 for a period of approximately one decade. A lot of the imagery or a lot of the photographs, which were also taken in video as well, has been shared on the dark net as well. The accused was arrested from Banda. He's likely to be produced before a court soon. A lot of searches have been done by the CBI. 8 mobile phones have been recovered, cash, money, sex toys, a laptop, other digital evidence as well. This is one of the most horrific cases that we've seen in a long time in something like this. Joining us now, Prabhat Kumar, head of Child Protection of Save the Children, the former Director General of Police, Mr. Vikram Singh, and Sheshmani Pandey, the District Magistrate of Chitrakoot. Sheshmani Pandey, if I can come to you first, what details can you share with us on how the CBI went about actually arresting this particular man? All right, I don't think we've got Sheshmani Pandey as yet. Let me go across to Mr. Prabhat Kumar. So this is a horrific case. It's taken place for 10 years right now. Your initial thoughts on what the CBI is unearthing at this stage?
I think first of all, we must congratulate CBI for unearthing something like this. There has been too many cases of child sexual abuse, and there has been evidences and researches that say that there is availability of child sexual abuse material and that has been supplied within country and outside. So first of all, we must thank that something like this has been accepted and there has been a case that is registered and someone has been arrested. What is surprising is that every time we see the cases like this, we must understand that there are 2-3 loopholes that are there. One, like you said, that this has been happening for 10 years and someone could continue a crime like this for 10 years. And we have laws like Protection of Children from Sexual Offences Act that has a stringent punishment on if someone is using children for sexual objectification or providing child pornography. So that has been there since 2012, but such people are not caught. And when such people are caught, at least there is acceptability within system. Second, so I think what must be made mandatory is, and this is something that organization like
Sir,
us has been asking for.
There's been a 22% jump in cases since 2017. 21,605 child rapes have been reported in 2018. For example, these are NCRB statistics. Of these 21,400 girls, 204 boys. It is a genuinely horrific figure. And it's just a sign of how prevalent this may be. But the fact of the matter is, this is just the tip of the iceberg. We really don't know how widespread pedophilia is.
Mr. Vishnu, yes, indeed, as you very rightly mentioned, that this is a grotesque crime, a despicable and an abhorrent crime. And what you also said is that the collected data and the recorded figures are just the tip of the iceberg. They represent not more than 20% of the genuine cases. 80% go by default and unreported. The substance abuse, the consumption of alcohol, pornography, these three create a heady mix. And then there are peddlers like this junior engineer who operate on the basis of economics and the law of demand and supply and pander to the wanton and irresponsible vices of the deviant. I would say that this is catering to the vices of the evil. And the less said, the better about the perversion of this junior engineer. But there's a lot that needs to be done by people like Mr. Prabhakar, the CBI, and the nation has to stand resolutely. POXO has come, but the deterrent punishment is very, very seldom that is given. The time has come that the topmost 100 cases must be given to the fast-track courts. Speedy justice and speedy trial and conviction must be ensured in these top 100 cases. And indeed, capital punishment has to be awarded, not as a matter of choice, but as a matter of compulsion, because society demands it. And the end of these monsters is a demand of the civilized society and of the nation. Vishnu.
Lalitha Kumaramangalam also joins us at this stage. Ma'am, this is an absolutely horrific case. Most of the victims were in the districts of Chitrakoot, Banda and Hamirpur. And the amount of evidence which has been recovered by the investigators, the CBI in this case, is huge. And the numbers of children who've suffered, 50 children plus, it just gives you an idea of how this was organized, and it was organized for such a long time. Is it your concern that the laws that we have need to be strengthened to protect against crime against children?
Vishnu, we have pretty good laws in India that actually try to prevent children's exploitation. The problem in India, and I've said this very often, is not about the laws, it's about the way the laws are implemented. Most children in India are not taught that they should complain if anybody touches them the wrong way, if anybody approaches them and, you know, makes them feel even uncomfortable. We shy away for a country that has the highest growing population of the world. We shy away from telling our children that certain things are wrong. The difference
That's
between
so great.
Wrong and right, we really are not teaching our young children. And, you know, you're quite right. This is such a highly organized crime. It's not just perversion, inhumane, evil. It's a crime. And this is, unfortunately, most people don't understand that after drugs, smuggling is, you know, and human trafficking is the biggest income earner generator in the world. And
yeah.
Children are trafficked for innumerable reasons, one of which is such horrible, you know, things that are done to them. Apparently, this guy who was, the guy who got caught, said quite has confessed quite openly that he used to bribe these children. We need to be able to teach, you know, it's not the fault of the poor child. You give him a sweet or you say that tumne ganda kaam kiya, main sabko bata dunga. This whole thing, obsession we have about always blaming the child or, and I mean, I'm especially if it's a girl child, and I'm not saying it's not done to little boys either, young boys either. But that, you know, we will shame you. Instead of the perpetrator being shamed, we shame the children. This is not just a law and law and order issue. This is also about the way society goes about these things. As a society, we need to change the, you know, the whole approach that we have to such crimes. Crimes
okay,
of violence against both
sure.
women and children.
Ma'am,
they
I'm
must
just,
stop
moment,
shaming
I
victims.
Want to go back to Mr. Prabhat Kumar. Sir, the point that Lalitha Kumaramangala makes is very important. That systemically within our school system, the difference between good touch and bad touch, what is a crime, what is not a crime, what is acceptable and what is not acceptable, is not perhaps taught in the same manner in which it should at the lowest levels. Village schools, district schools, schools in small towns, where there is a certain stigma about talking about things like this. Is that in your line of work something that you have seen? Children are not informed enough. About these very important threats.
Yeah, in fact, that is one of the biggest challenges. In fact, I see this as crisis where there are three level challenges. One is about awareness among children, their parents and teachers. So that is something we have seen is very less. How much of education system is pushed towards making sure that there is cyber safety there, if cyber crime is happening or if children are being misused, how do they report the safe touch and unsafe touch? Where do they report? What action will be taken? So those awareness raising session needs to be integrated within our education system. That is from the children and parents perspective, because if something is going on for 10 years and there has been more than 50 children who have been abused, I'm sure if they, someone must have known where to report, how to get treat. We know that fear factor is one of them, but awareness is one of important thing. And creating those reporting mechanisms that if you report, you are people will listen to you and there will be action taken. So report and response is important. But whenever we have worked in our field, we have seen that one of the biggest challenges awareness amongst children and their parents about cyber crime or cyber safety.
All right, I'd like to thank you all very much for joining us. It's such a horrific crime. We really do need to reflect on this. The fact that it's been happening for 10 years in parts of Uttar Pradesh, in a couple of districts, 50 plus children who've been targeted, who've been sexually abused, who've been filmed with those videos being transferred to the dark web. They were apparently bribed into silence as well. That's how this junior engineer, who's now been caught by the CBI, that's how he used to operate.